Building is a fundamental and essential trait. Without it, you can't research since you're incapable of constructing a research bench. So with that in mind, I decided to go for a new challenge to see if I can beat Rimworld without building, deconstructing, or repairing a single entity. Our ideology prefers living in poor conditions, very aesthetic for this challenge. With all these traits in mind, let's begin. We plunge into our forest with Balisar here. She has decent planting crafting traits with negative 99 construction, which is exquisite. My plan for now is to chop down some wood for a ranged weapon. We can build a crafting spot, which doesn't require colonist construction. I was curious about this blowgun, so we gathered herbal medicine and wood to craft it. We prolonged our product, but eventually it was completed. Let's begin the evaluation of the blowgun, shall we? The turkey ended up getting toxic buildup, which is not viable, so I go ahead and make a bow instead. The prodigious hunt began as more turkeys were hunted for Thanksgiving. The forest was quiet as the sound of wind striking the leaves made me leave. I relocate my possessions into this abandoned shack where I can sleep on top of a destroyed bed. It's better than the floor, at least. Butchering begins as we gather resources necessary for crafting. I order Balisar to craft a knife and a veil for early raids. A steel deposit south of base satisfy our requirements for this. After assembling the knife, we get a trader whom sells nothing worthwhile. I work on more potential weapons as we have dual wield, allowing us to wield two weapons at once. As well as that, I create throwing knives and dual wield that. It was quite effective at killing, to say the least. A mad gazelle gazed upon our lands and ended up hunting me. Its speed meant I had to hit its leg first. I got greedy and thought I had time to stop to shoot more accurately, but I was wrong and took a few hits. We heal up and commence a plan to get a pre-built base. I'm going to attack a base and try to take over it. If I can win, I can acquire premium and potential recruits. We wander through the fields when our caravan gets ambushed by a modded entity. The enemy is quite swift as he eventually catches up to us and engages in melee combat. Luckily, we shred him down and regroup for the next challenge. I arrive at a magnificent structure which resembles a great castle. I have to get to work, so I attack this wall over here. The second wall reveals a luxurious village with a nice lake. I count about 11 to 12 pirates whom I will slay later. I make my way and destroy the castle towers as they can contain a place for me to sleep. This one in specific had a lot of weaponry. The revolver was superb, so I established it into my loadout. The tower east contained a lot of skulls and prison cells. I thought I was the only one committing war crimes here. This base had caravan reinforcements that would arrive soon. I better hurry. The tower south revealed nothing, so I break down west and notice a pirate lurking around. Eventually, I pass through and break the tower, which revealed more organs. A lot has been going on in here, huh? I think of a plan and decide on bringing another weapon that would help me. This explosive stick would come in handy. This wall right here is out of sight of turrets and such, so I broke in. I tried to fire the boomstick against a sleeping raider. Somehow, she could sleep again, so I fired once more. She must have intense dementia. If she forgets, she got hurt. The last explosion killed her. Strip the corpse of its clothes and equip it. I make an opening in case something goes wrong, and eventually they were starving and decided to attack me. Thanks to the layered walls, I can walk right through them, but they were following me. I have to be quick. They destroy my bed and their own people, relieving me of some work. Eventually, they catch up as I lead them to a corner. I shoot hastily as they try to take cover. One of the pirates pushed me as the loud bang of the guns tore her down. Dawn arose as I hid behind a tree. This pirate engaged in melee activity, so I move up for a short opening for me to shoot. I head through the corridor once more as I fiercely shoot both of my guns. I was on a rampage and decided to kill the rest of the pirates. More came over as I hit for 24 damage. Unfortunately, more reinforcements come, so I have to run and gun my way back towards the tower. I shoot backwards as I run forwards, hitting many shots. Eventually they caught up, so I continue on. The intense 1v1 between Balisar and India began. Eventually, with my shooting speed, I pierce through their armor, killing them. This autocannon has limited range, so I began destroying it. The IED went off as this autocannon started hissing. I got out on time as even more reinforcements arrive. I take cover in the northeastern tower and start shooting at the pirate, eventually downing her. I wanted to capture her, but without any rooms, that isn't really possible. The last pirate engaged as we had a vigorous fight. Eventually, we end up victorious. Afterwards, I took on the turrets with a long-range rifle, which took a long time. But we break both of the machines down. Eventually, more raiders arrived as I shoot them down. I ran down the corridor with both my guns in hand. Then I run down further as I continue to mow them down. Eventually, one shot after the other, both of them perish beneath my feet. To stop more reinforcements, I have to take out the last of the turrets, so I head for this cannon over here. I tried shooting it down, but I had a better plan. I would use my boomstick to manually trigger the anti-grain warhead. With a few shots, I was almost there. And the last shot brought upon an almighty explosion. I was one cell from dying, but with this angle, Balisar survived. For the last turret, I get an angle where I could get close to it. It misses both shots, and eventually I'm in range where I can destroy it whilst it cannot destroy me. The last sound of explosion upon the region occurred as it blew up the mortar next to it. With the battle finally over, we can relax. I explored the village, which revealed a handful amount of items and structures. I stumbled across another turret, which scared me wholeheartedly. After that, I uncovered the last building, which had weapons, wonderful. And the one beneath it had better weapons and even a bionic construction arm. How this game messes with us sometimes. I claim the entire castle and establish our homes here, harvesting the corn for temporary food and hauling everything indoors. We work efficiently at getting the base up again. The area was covered with a thin layer of smoke from all the explosions, but we carry on. Eventually, another raid popped up once again. With a sniper, I annihilate this guy's torso. The well-placed anti-grain delivered a shocking explosion, shaking the earth beneath, which triggered them to leave. I mean, I would be surprised if they would still assault us. For my previous fight, I ended up getting an infection in my torso, which could be lethal. I'm barely above the threshold as I start extracting beer for future silver. This infection was the most fatal thing yet, and somehow we survived. Momentarily after, a few traders show up, whom I will sell a few weapons and resources to. Components didn't matter at all here. After that, we get another trader. This one had very good armor, which is crucial here. I can only afford a helmet, but the head is the most important part anyway. I haul the silver back into the base swiftly, and our mood was all over the place. We need junk around to increase it, but it's okay for now. We then get a transpod crash. It turns out she has an addiction, which is never viable, so I finish her off. Balisar was very sad and decided to drink. We hate alcohol, but what can we do? As we were wandering around sadly, a black hive decided to assault us. They quickly broke into our compound and started destroying everything. Luckily, Bali got over the sadness and we can finally fight back. We run over with our guns and engage. With our new guns, we penetrate armor like it's butter, which promptly led to the death of the black hive bugs. The only thing we can do is move buildings, so I decide to move batteries accordingly so I can power up this turret. My great castle attracted even more raiders, tribals with swords. Not a problem. Except they talked about eating without tables. What kind of psychopaths are these people? They commence fighting, but I'm ready with my turret, buddy. They came swarming with knives. I came with my guns. Don't bring knives to a gunfight. One of the tribals has blended traits, and I will need a few recruits, so I tend to orange while a great fire was set ablaze. I captured a tribal and let him lay down with a headless corpse. The colony was at peace while wealth had risen tremendously. 75,000 silver is not ideal. I then get the Empire Deserter quest. I am contemplating if I should accept this or not. I can get a good recruit with decent armor, but then I will get raids from them in the future. I take my chances and decide to recruit Honorus. Shortly after, the Empire are on my trail. They break down the door while we wait patiently. They start attacking while the turret will unfortunately go down. With Run and Gun though, we take many of them down and eventually the two of them are dead. The last one fled, unfortunately. I decide to convert Honor for now because having to manage two ideologies is
ideal.
We work on converting both the prisoners and eventually manage to do so. They do not like each other a lot though. I then get another raid from the Panthermen. This time I was smart and made use of the anti-grain warhead, but the pirates didn't even manage to stop to think and still rushed in with their pride at their heart. Unfortunately though, I destroyed their hearts, so no luck with that. I shredded through the pirates as their weapons didn't have a lot of armor penetration. The bolt action guy was very annoying, so I shoot his brain out. We tend to ourselves as not long after we get another raid, who also decides to trip on my anti-grain warhead. I snipe them from afar, dealing damage before they arrive. It worked and they fled with fear. We haul everything and eventually convert Honorus. For now, we need food for our next mission, the ship launch quest. Not long after, we recruit Orange as well and start stocking up on food. Orange will become Soul Light from Patreon and mines jade that we can sell later. I work further on the base as we gather more silver or selling. To stock up on all items, I require animals, so I work on taming them. A caravan passes by our base and they had some animals, which is perfect timing. I sell off almost all of our steel and components. They end up entering the turret room, which turned out to be good because they destroyed it. We haul corn from the harsh outdoor environment as we are finally ready for our presumptuous journey. Firstly, I would like to sell our resources, so we're going for the Outlander traders. We select everyone and start packing. Eventually we leave and abandon our settlement. We eventually arrive where I will buy a marine helmet and sell a lot of weapons. I will also buy a psychic pacifier from Vanilla Expanded, which can recruit people. We sell off some other stuff and start our roam towards the ship launch quest. It's one of the very first quests in Rimworld, so let's take advantage of that. Eventually we get ambushed by a tribal and head out. We run out of food, so I take a detour to trade for 12 lavish meals. It still wasn't enough, so I harvest some berries nearby and head on out. Eventually, we get ambushed again by a pirate, but he actually did a lot of damage and shot off Soulite's toe. We regroup, and with enough food and warm clothing, we arrive 7 days later. We set our home area and decide to move all of our walls around the ship. Since we can't construct, this will be our only line of defense. It took a very long time to move the walls, but eventually we end up with a bunch of damaged walls with a singular choke point. We rest for a while and haul junk into the area. Before long, we get a manhunter pack whom we shred down very easily. At long last, we're going to take on the raids that are coming. We activate the ship as the sound of hell approaches. Not long, we get our raid from the Empire immediately. You can use the ship pods to rest in, which is fantastic. To combat this raid, we use our pacifiers to recruit 2 melee Imperials and quickly start shattering everyone in range. They stand no chance as we kick, slice, and dice them. We win. Not long after, we get a tribal raid, but the raid went horribly wrong. A few Genixes started attacking the tribals. Eventually, they take care of most of them and we wait. They came rushing in with no chance of killing us. One tribal was left as we shoot a hole through him. We equip stronger weapons and armor as we seal ourselves off from the environment for the next raid. It was quiet for an evening as corpses rotted next to us. Eventually, we get another Empire raid, so with our choke point, we shoot endlessly. With high armor penetrating weapons, we shred through each and every one of them. Not for long, we get Lancers and Cyphers. We engage and slaughter every single one of the machine bits. Balisar tends while she vomits over Kyo. Not very fancy. Another tribal raid approaches as we shoot them down easily. They came in short bursts, which is a relief. Our simple hole is very effective. They don't stand a chance as our walls were being destroyed. The last ones die as another raid emerges. They break a hole through the wall and start engaging us. We kill them in the shadows of the smoke while screaming filled our ears. They entered blindly, not knowing we were silent assassins. Unfortunately, honor got down and we were bleeding out. We kill the rest of them as two of our colonists get down. After tending and after half a day, everyone is back up as we go berserk. Not a very good sign with the monosaur down. The Fermite breaks our walls as we await. We charge in. But I have a plan. Shortly after killing this Lancer, we deploy our low shield belt from one of our purchases. The Fermites and everything else don't stand a chance as we kill them. No rest as more tribals decide to swarm in at a fast rate. We have grown familiar with war, so we quickly mow them down while our shooting skill increases. Our moods are absolutely shattered as more raids come in. Ferals engage as they are tougher to kill. But everyone must die at some point. We spend the next days butchering, stripping, and hauling everyone for fun. War crimes before we leave. Ferals arrive once again as unfortunately two of our Imperial colonists have almost perished. We fight and fight continuously as we have to back up. They infiltrate our defenses, but fortunately we kill them off satisfyingly. The last one had now died. It has been 15 days as we are now ready for ship launch. We activate as we descend into space. Thank you for watching and thanks to my supporters. And if you're bored, then watch these videos next.